make your hair more stronger and make the cornrows easier to cornrow also. The braids more easy to cornrow when you add weave. You just look more neater. You just cornrow, keep cornrowing to the one you already done. You want to stay with every time. Call Sanford Brown at 855-407-1444 to reserve your class pass for December 17th. That's all. You don't want to braid too much because you want to be able to connect the braids and you want it to look good once you start connecting. Okay, so I'm going to get completely vanished, and I'll come back. Guys, I am almost finished. I just wanted to show you guys how much I have left. What I like to do is go ahead and just section this out so I can get these cornrow correctly. So I am almost finished. I'm excited. Still nice and detangled. So let me finish these few braids, and I'll come back at you and let you see the cornrow style I came up with, okay? Officially done, and you don't have to make them edges all tight, just kind of take them out and put some little stuff on them. There's no need for cornrows to be super tight. So I'm finished with the cornrows, just kind of check it out, make sure it's how you want it. Make sure the way that it's going to be laying right. I love the way it's going to be laying. But you never want to go back too far back. So let me go ahead and get the braid pattern done, and I'll show you how to crochet it. Okay, so now section off. From ear to ear, or wherever your braid stopped at, go ahead and section that off. And put the rest on the back in a ponytail. Or section all about your way. Okay, so now what I'm about to do is I'm about to just make one big cornrow going around the crown of the head. And again, I'm setting my hair up now for the crochet. Any loose hairs, cut it, because you know that's the weave hair. And just start doing a cornrow. Make sure it's nice and tight and try to make it as little as possible. Take each braid one by one so you're going to have a big, huge bulk. So you see what I'm doing? Just taking each cornrow and making it into one big cornrow. Making sure you're picking up each cornrow. See, so far all you're picking up is the ends. You just do it slow because you don't want it to be have a big, huge bulk cornrow at the top. If you got to add product to the hair, most definitely do that because you're supposed to have it on the ends of your hand. So you can, like right here on the palm, so you better get to it. Just keep going and making one nice big cornrow. So let me go ahead and make the cornrow and I'll be back. And what you're going to do is make sure you braid all the way down. Because that's when you get a nice cornrow. And it lays flat, and that's what you want for it to lay flat. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually take this, and when I start doing my cornrows, I'm going to connect it to here so it'll be added. So you see that? That actually is a whole hairstyle in itself. If you want to, you can wear it like this and have your afro. But like I said, I'm putting crochet weave in. So let me get my braid pattern together. So basically what you do first is cornrow your front of your hair however you want to. And then you just do the rest of it. What I want to let you know is what you're going to do is take this big cornrow that you've done. You're going to add it to this hair. So once I get done cornrowing, I'll show you how it looks. And like I said, make sure this cornrow right here is nice and flat. Because once you start adding the crochet weave, you want it to be nice and flat. Okay? Okay. And the way that I'm going to do the top, I'm actually not even going to really like focus on parting like specific, but I just want to pull out a certain amount of hair because like I said, I'm doing horizontal and I'm just going to keep on going. Just make sure it's horizontal. And it's straight. So I'm going to start braiding horizontal. I want to make sure it's straight. Okay, there you go. Just keep braiding horizontally. And I'm going to add some weave to it because like I told you, to me, my hair holds better to weave. And plus, it's a protective style and with the weave, it protects my hair. You don't got to add a whole bunch of weave, just a little something. And every time you add weave, you want to add the product, whatever product that you added to your hair to detangle it. So again, I'm going to be going braiding horizontal. I'm not going to add that end piece right here until I get down to that section. And like I said, you're not getting graded on these braids, just as long as they're going horizontal. And when you lay the crochet, it looks good. And I'm just going to just braid and connect braids. So this is the first braid, and I'm going to just keep going straight, connecting braids. I just kind of put the comb in there just so it can get it started off so I can have a nice straight row. And I just make the horizontal part get bigger and bigger as I go down. Just kind of think of it like laying tracks. You want them straight, just like you lay a track. So let me finish a few and I'll show you the end result. Okay, see now I'm down here getting a little lower. And what I did was I added this cornrow to my other cornrow. And when I was going, again, I'm going. And I added to this, and now I'm about to just continue to keep braiding.
Okay. I'm officially done corn rolling my hair. What I did, again, I did the back horizontal, and I just sewed it up right there. So once I start my crocheting process, there's no loose hairs. And I just did it. It wasn't perfect. You don't got to do the corn rolls perfect as long as it's horizontal and connecting. And that's pretty much it. So I'm going to do a few crochet weaving on camera just to give you a general idea. And then once I'm finished, I'm going to show you the end results. If you have any questions, please let me know.